According to research published in the Journal of the American Chemical Society, University of Birmingham scientists are paving the way to swap the lithium in lithium-ion batteries with sodium. Lithium-ion batteries, LIB, are rechargeable and are widely used in laptops, mobile phones, and in hybrid and fully electric vehicles. The electric vehicle is a crucial technology for fighting pollution in cities and realizing an era of clean, sustainable transport. However, lithium is expensive and resources are unevenly distributed across the planet. Large amounts of drinking water are used in lithium extraction, and extraction techniques are becoming more energy intensive as lithium demand rises. With the ever-increasing demand for electric cars, the need for reliable rechargeable batteries is rising dramatically. So there is keen interest in finding a charge carrier other than lithium that is cheap and easily accessible. Sodium is inexpensive and can be found in seawater, so is virtually limitless. However, sodium is a larger ion than lithium, so it is not possible to simply swap it for lithium in current technologies. For example, unlike lithium, sodium will not fit between the carbon layers of the ubiquitous LIB anode graphite. The scientists needed to find new materials to act as battery components for sodium ion batteries that will compete with lithium for capacity, speed of charge, energy, and power density. Running quantum mechanical models on supercomputers, the research team from the University of Birmingham was able to predict what happens when sodium is inserted into phosphorus. In collaboration with a team at the University of Cambridge, who performed the experiments which have verified the predictions, they found that the phosphorus forms helixes at intermediate stages of charging. The researchers identified the final composition of the electrode, which provides a final capacity of charge carriers 7 times that of graphite for the same weight. This gives fresh insights into how to make high-capacity sodium ion anodes. According to the researchers, this is a huge win for computational materials science.